Hello world, this is Coco Martech, and today we're going to compare two very affordable and similar Android smartphones that you can buy right now. This is the Tecno Spark 6 Go versus the Infinix Smart 5.
TT with Coco Martech.
Let's start with the display. These two phones are like siblings. Every category will be almost identical in this comparison video, and so with the display. The Spark 6 Go has a 6.52-inch HD Plus LCD screen, having 720 by 1600 pixels with 269 pixels per inch, as compared to the Smart 5 having a 6.6 HD Plus LCD screen, again with 720 by 1600 pixels with 261 pixels per inch. Slight difference in pixels per inch because the Smart 5 has a slightly bigger screen, but you won't be able to see the difference in real life if you're going to compare the phones by side by side. You also have the same brightness level for both phones, both have 60Hz refresh rates, both have an aspect ratio of 20:9, both do not have wide color gamut. Even with color tests, these two phones are identical, so this part is a draw for me. Next up is build quality. The Spark 6 Go has dimensions of 165.6 by 76.3 by 9.1 millimeters, and it weighs at 193 grams, while the Smart 5 has dimensions of 165 by 75.4 by 8.75 millimeters, and it weighs at 183 grams. Both phones have plastic backs and plastic frames. The build quality of both phones are great for their prices. Even though their backs are made of plastic, they actually feel like glass except when you tap on the materials. But really, their finishings are solid for their price. Even though the Smart 5 is officially thinner since it has a thickness of 8.75 millimeters compared to the Spark 6 Go with 9.1 millimeters, you won't be able to see the difference. In terms of ergonomics, both phones are easy to hold since both are lightweight and both have slightly curved backs. Again, build quality is a draw for me. Moving on, we have the design comparison. The Spark 6 Go comes with three color variants, the Mystery White, Aqua Blue, and Ice Jadeite, while the Smart 5 comes with Quetzal Cyan, Ocean Wave, and Midnight Black. For the front, both phones again identical since they both have a water drop notch style with thin side bezels and a huge chin. The difference between the two will be the design of the back, since the Spark 6 Go has a shifting, reflecting gradient design with diagonals. Not really sure with the name of that style design, but with the Smart 5, it has a stylish gem cut style. Obviously, this is going to be subjective, so comment down below which design do you prefer. Personally, I like the Spark 6 Go since it looks a little cleaner to me, and don't get me wrong, even though this is not a sponsored video, I still like the design of the Smart 5. Another thing to compare is the layout of the camera lenses. The Spark 6 Go has two camera lenses, having a flash in the middle of the two lenses, while the Smart 5 also has two camera lenses, but since it looks like it has three lenses because it has a third circle at the bottom and it says AI, I'd prefer the layout of the Spark 6 Go since I got tricked that the Smart 5 has three lenses. You also have the logo at the back, wherein the Spark 6 Go is located at the lower left part, while the Smart 5 has the Infinix logo underneath the fingerprint scanner and another logo located below. For me, less is simpler and simpler is better. Lastly, the fingerprint scanner for the Spark 6 Go is circular, while the Smart 5 is a box with rounded corners. Again, this part is going to be subjective, but for the design comparison, overall, I'd go with the Spark 6 Go. Next, let's tackle one of our favorite parts of a smartphone, the cameras. Well, Filipinos love taking photos anyway. The cameras for the Spark 6 Go are the following: an 8 megapixel selfie camera with one flash and two rear lenses, one 13 megapixel for the main camera and one 8 megapixel for the bokeh or portrait mode. On the other hand, the Smart 5 has 8 megapixel selfie camera with dual flash and two rear cameras with 8 megapixel main lens and 8 megapixel portrait or bokeh mode. For this comparison, the margin is not really wide, but I like the camera of the Spark 6 Go a little better since it produces less noise during low light and generally it produces much cleaner images. One advantage of the Smart 5 is the dual front-facing flash for the selfie camera. The Smart 5 produces more contrast compared to the Spark 6 Go, but again, the Spark 6 Go produces less noise. In most shots, both produce identical images, especially with lots of sunlight and wide angle shots like roads and house exteriors.
This is a comparison video of the selfie video of the Spark 6 Go versus the Smart 5. So which one is better in terms of video quality and audio quality coming from their microphones? Again, comment down below. This is a comparison video of the rear cameras for taking videos of the Spark 6 Go versus the Smart 5. Comment down below which one is better in terms of the overall production of the video quality, and also the audio quality coming from their microphones. So again, comment down below which one is better for you.
In terms of taking videos, both can capture 1080p, 30 frames per second, and for me, they are similar too. For the cameras, I'm going with the Spark 6 Go for the rear camera since it produces more detailed photos thanks to the 13 megapixel main lens and captures less noise in low light, but I'm going with the Smart 5 for the selfie camera since I really like that dual flash. Speed is next in our comparison, and here I have a clear winner, the Spark 6 Go. On paper, the difference between the phones should be slim, but based in real life usage, the Spark 6 Go feels much faster than the Smart 5. It's less laggy and produces less frame drops when playing games. The Spark 6 Go has a 2 GHz 12 nanometer MediaTek Helio A20 quad-core processor with a GPU of PowerVR GE8300, while the Smart 5 has a 1.8 GHz 12 nanometer MediaTek Helio A20 quad-core processor with a GPU of PowerVR GE8320. In terms of benchmarks, the Spark 6 Go also edges the Smart 5, beating in both single core and multi core in Geekbench 5. Both phones have a 2GB of RAM and 32GB of internal storage variant, and a 3GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage variant. Although I have not yet found someone selling online a 3GB of RAM and 64GB storage variant for the Smart 5. So, for the speed comparison, the winner is the Spark 6 Go. We're almost at the end game, and next stop is the battery comparison. Both the Spark 6 Go and the Smart 5 have 5000 mAh of battery with the traditional micro USB charging, and the battery life based on my testing is also nearly identical. Charging time for both phones are also slow since they have the large non-removable 5000 mAh of battery. 20% of charging is around 30 to 40 minutes, and that is extremely slow, especially today when fast charging is becoming a trend. So battery is a tie for me. In terms of software, the Spark 6 Go is using the HiOS 6.2, while the Smart 5 has the Dolphin OS 6.2, both on top of Android 10. HiOS 6.2 and Dolphin 6.2 are also identical since Infinix and Tecno Mobile are sister companies. Both have the same functionalities, but I like the aesthetics of the Dolphin OS a little better. So the winner for me for the software is going to be Smart 5. But yeah, that is kind of subjective. Lastly, we have the speakers. Sound is a big part of the experience since watching videos or playing games with bad speakers may ruin the whole experience. While both phones provide the same okay quality with the same loudness and bass, I still prefer the bottom firing speaker over the back firing speaker. So for me, for the speakers, the winner is going to be Smart 5. Just a note, both phones also have fingerprint scanners and face unlock, and both provide the same experience. Both located at the back of your phone with a minor design difference, but both with the same speed and same reliability. Given with the price for both phones, 3,990 pesos for the 2GB RAM, 32GB internal storage variant, and 5,490 pesos for the 3GB of RAM and 64GB of internal storage variant, I'm picking the Spark 6 Go because it really feels fast compared to the Smart 5. The aspects are again nearly identical, like the build quality, camera, software experience, battery performance, and the performance to price ratio. Both the Spark 6 Go and the Smart 5 are good buys, and you'll never go wrong with either phone. But again, if I had to choose one, I'm going with the Tecno Mobile Spark 6 Go. So, which phone do you prefer? Comment down below. You can buy the phone right away because I'll be putting the affiliate link in the description box down below. So, make sure to click them so you can order one right now. Or both. So, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed. This is Coco Martech, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.